Hello, welcome to Fun Stats. Today's topic is the relationships between age, gender, and happiness. Does our happiness change as we get older? Does gender have any effects on our happiness? Are there any tendencies depending on the countries? Today, we consider these questions. Today's discussion is mainly based on the World Happiness Report 2015. Especially Chapter 3, How Does Subjective Well-Being Vary Around the World by Gender and Age? It was written by Nicole Fortin, John Halliwell, and Sean Wang. The report was based on the Gallup World Poll for 10 years, from 2005 to 2014. Let's see the features. This is the survey result of life evaluation by gender and age. The red line shows females' evaluation, and blue indicates the males. What can we infer from this? First, differences by age and gender are relatively small, compared to the other elements. Second, in almost all age groups, females have higher life evaluations than males. Third, both genders show the life evaluation declines with age. Highest in teenage groups, decreases toward the lowest point in middle age, and stays roughly constant over the rest of their lives. This means that, on a global average basis, women are more likely to feel happiness than men, and both genders' happiness tends to decrease as we get older. Then, are there any tendencies depending on the countries? Let's see characteristics. First, we can observe U-shapes in North America and East Asia. This means, although your happiness would decline to the age of 40 or 50, it would recover after that, in those areas. Second, this tendency doesn't apply to the other regions. Amongst them, Russia and Eastern Europe displayed a sharp falling trend. Third, the most significant gender differences were observed in the Middle East and North Africa, though sometimes pointed out that women's rights need to be improved in those areas. Results show that women feel more happiness than men, contrary to the expectations. Fourth, in Western Europe, it follows a downward trend to age 50, and flat after that. The gender gap favors men for the first time after age 50. Then, how about the relationships between age, gender, and emotions? Our happiness is affected by our daily emotions. Let's see some traits. First, the transition of laugh and enjoyment are similar. Younger, specifically female people, report more frequently these traits. Approaching middle age, these drop significantly. And at midlife, gender crossover happens. Second, feeling rested shows the U-shape. It means you might feel unrested and fatigued until age 40 to 50. But it would recover after that. This could be good news for some. Your fatigue is not everlasting. Third, an enormous gender gap was found in feeling safe at night. Females are less likely to feel safe at night than males. Especially in North America, Western Europe, and Eastern Europe, this tendency is more common. On the contrary, women in East and Southeast Asia feel safer in general. Fourth, when it comes to learning or doing something interesting, it favors males over females across the whole age group, though averages in both sexes are low. Next, how about negative emotions? If our happiness declines as we get older, what is the contributing factor for the downward curve? Anger could have harmful effects on our happiness, but it becomes less prevalent in old ages. Sadness is more widely reported in female and higher age groups. The report analyzes that women have more willingness to discuss emotional problems, which might contribute to a greater frequency of sadness in females. Stress generally shows hill shape in ages. Areas where stresses are reported more frequently are North America and East Asia. The hill shape coincides with the U-shape and happiness age relations in North America and East Asia. So, if you are in North America or East Asia, your stress might be eased around age 40 to 50, which could improve your happiness significantly. Worry tends to rise in all age groups and be felt more frequently in women. The most remarkable upward trends were observed in Russia and Eastern Europe. Pains, particularly chronic pains, are more frequently reported in higher age and female groups. In addition to emotions, what is the external factor crucial for our happiness? To put it simply, we focus on two aspects here: health problems and social supports. Health problems show strikingly similar tendencies all over the world. It generally starts below 20% at age 20 and rises to around 50% at age 70. Women report health problems more frequently than men. Social support in this context means having someone to count on when needed. On a world basis, declining trends for both genders can be seen. The lowest average was observed in South Asia. So, what is the conclusion today? Do people become unhappier as they get older? Based on the statistics, the answer is basically yes. But please remember that this is just an average tendency. It does not necessarily mean that this applies to you or any other specified persons. Based on that, what should we do to feel more happiness as we get older? I think the key is the factors which have shown the biggest movements with ages. Those were the worry, pain, social support, and health problems. So, today's conclusion would be this. First, take care of your health conditions. Health problems and pains are big contributors to your unhappiness. Exercise moderately on a regular basis and prevent illness and diseases. Second, keep good relationships with your families and friends. Join communities and connect with others. As experts argue, keeping social bonds is the key to our happiness. Lastly, knowing general tendencies regarding age, happiness, and emotions could be helpful. We can make use of them to understand our situations and prepare for the future. I hope you enjoy this video. Please do not forget to subscribe. See you soon.